Hello, YouTubers. Grumpy old man here. Almost the end of March. It's the Friday. Whatever the Friday is. Don't make me bother looking it up. Don't care. Ends with a Y. Sun shining. Warm enough to maybe take the vest off. Or just take the sleeves off it. I'm not doing a product thing, but this, the liner to my jacket, it's convertible. I haven't had a chance to do that much with it. But, you know, lots of you probably think you haven't had a chance to do much with anything in your home now. Or if you have to work, my heart goes out to you. Can't imagine what some of you have to deal with. So now I make myself a little more comfortable. I got people on social media talking about how it was all a big conspiracy with the drug companies. Well, maybe if you're afraid and you live in a country without social supports, it's really got to be freaking you out. You know, I can't imagine what an American has to go through right now. You know, there's countries all over the world, 150 of them now, on lockdown. This plague is sweeping through. You can shoot your conspiracy theories right up your backside. The flu, which we normally get, about 0.1% die. And we kind of sort of accept that, you know. In this country, we can get a flu shot for free. Then you get the ones that say, oh, it's this or that. Okay, you make your own choices. COVID is like 1%. That's 10 times as bad. 10 times as bad. And people still won't stop gathering. Stay home. You know, I'm watching, you know, Italian mayors effing off people who won't stay home. I get it. I'm in the middle of a move and I want to keep doing it. It's like, gotta stay home. Gotta wait for this plague to sweep through. And I can, well, in the meantime, I'm packing stuff up. You can see over my shoulder. I can't get out anyway. There's a lake behind me. Can't move the camper. I see the feet are pushing into the soft ground. I'll have to fix that as soon as I can. And when all this snow is out of here, when the travel restrictions are off, yeah, pack it up and go. But in the meantime, folks, if you don't have to go anywhere, don't. Last night, one of my friends was saying, oh, you can get beer delivered. Not out here, you can't. Oh, yeah, just get the local restaurant to do a takeaway and bring 10 kilometers from the village, and that restaurant hasn't got a bar stocked for selling booze. Later that night, I see my favorite brewery out of Perth. They're offering home delivery if you get enough, because they're up to running around to the shops anyway. They got to sell their product. Shout out to the distillery in Perth, Top Shelf, and the one in Almont, who are making hand sanitizers. Almont is they use the milk sugars, and they make vodka is their product. They just donated a truckload of sanitizer to the hospital in Ottawa, and they're giving it to the paramedics in Renfrew, and they're probably doing the same thing in Lanark. Yeah, people, figure out what you've got. You know, the paramedics were saying, well, you know, for 4 months we've been trying to get supplies. It comes out of China. Those factories are shut down. The test, the swab test, they're manufactured in Italy. Can't get it from there either. Rubber gloves, face masks, they just aren't enough. It's worse than hoarding toilet paper. But vets are turning over supplies. Plastic surgeons have respirators. They're turning them over. Dyson is making 1,500 of them. Or 15,000 of them. Yeah, yeah. Absolutely. Focus on, you know, the government will pay you for that stuff, and some of them are just donating it. stay safe, folks. It's a plague. Keep the politics out of it. It's a plague. And my heart goes out to people who can't just go to the hospital or can't call their doctor or can't afford to do anything. My heart goes out to you folks. May you still be watching this. In a month or two or three from now, when we're on the other side of it, because we're all in this together. And if you're sitting at home twiddling your thumbs, make something, post something, just like I'm doing. I'm thinking, it's time to sit down with my dad and get another one of Smitty's stories. Well, I can't go into the city and see him. The man's like 81 in 2 months. Yeah, you just stay there, in your condo cocoon. Everything's good. We'll just wait for this to blow over. Because if enough of us stop moving, this thing will die. Because the virus doesn't move, we move. We take it places. If we stop, it has to die. We just got to stop going places. Just got to stop seeing people. Stop doing things you don't need to be doing. Sit down, relax, take a breath, and focus on what needs to be done. That's Grumpy Old Man with my sage advice. Something to kill less than 10 minutes of your time watching. Thank you very much. Ask your friends. Share it. Feedback. Don't write me a message. Now write your own, do your own video response and post it. We can all share, what's going on. I keep telling people, I'm not going to die of starvation. The ducks are producing eggs again. If they stop producing eggs, I've threatened to show them the movie Chicken Run. There's a lot of birds here I could eat before I have to worry about starvation. The one behind me has to be last. I can freak people out. They say make jokes. Mike, bring on the dad jokes, the sick humor. Bring it on. Because it's better than no humor at all. So you're thinking of something funny. Go for it. Spit it out there. Share it with us. Have a good time. Stay safe. I could ramble all day and my friends know it. Take care, folks.